Hi, I'm Summit Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Barry by my students, and today is lesson number 11 for the Computer Proficiency, also known as the Computer Literacy course. Now, this will be the second lesson where we're working with Google Sheets. So, let's get started with the lesson. Thus far, we have been using Google Sheets in home and business spreadsheets, but Google Sheets can be a very handy tool in better understanding scientific measurements as well. So in this lesson, you'll be creating a number of spreadsheets and charts to fine-tune the skills learned in lesson number 10. First off, highest mountains on the earth. So what we're going to do is start your Chrome browser or your Chromebook and log into your Google account. From there, we need to go into your apps icon. That may, if you're in a Windows machine, that'll be found on your bookmarks bar. The app screens will load, showing the apps that are installed on your account. Click on the Google Drive icon, as seen here. Once you've clicked on the Google Drive icon, the Google Drive will load, as seen here. Number 6, double-click on your projects folder to open it. Number 7, once the project folder opens, you will see the documents that you have created in the past. Number 8, click on the New button. 9, a menu will pop down. 10, click on the green Google Sheets icon. 11, if you're asked to create this document in a shared folder, then click the blue OK button. 12. The Google Sheets will load. 13. Give this spreadsheet the title, Project 13 Highest Mountains. You do this by typing in the new title and hitting in the Enter key once. The new title, remember, goes where it says Untitled Spreadsheet. Number 14. After naming the spreadsheet, the blank sheet should be visible as seen here. The title will be appearing above the word file where it says Project 13 Highest Mountains, and there's no data yet in any of the cells. Step 15, take your mouse and click in cell A1 and then drag the mouse across while you're still holding down the clicker all the way to H. And this will highlight row number 1 from column A to column H as seen here in step number 15. After highlighting those cells, we're now ready for step 16. Click on the Merge command to merge these cells into one long cell. Number 17. Click on the Center command to center the text within the cell. So you click on this icon and then click on the Center icon, which looks like this on step 17. Now we're ready for step 18. 18, the spreadsheet should look like this. 19, take your mouse and click on Insert from the menu bar. The Insert menu should appear. 20, from the Insert menu, click on the Drawing command. 21, the Insert Drawing window should open as seen here. 22. Click on Actions from within the Insert Drawing window. A menu should appear below the word Actions. 23. Click on Word Art from within the Action menu as seen here. 24. a new text box should appear as seen here. 25. Key in highest mountains in the text box provided and then hit the enter key once. 26. After hitting the enter key, the word art should appear as seen here, where it says highest mountains. 27. After seeing it where it says highest mountains, you may now click on the save and close button. 28. The spreadsheet should look like this now, where it says highest mountains. 29. Take your mouse and right click on the number 1 over here while I'm pointing. This is the first row. When you right click on that number 1, a context menu should appear right out of the 1. Step 30. Click on Resize Row from the context menu. The Resize Row window should appear now, as seen here. 32. Key in 128 to change the row height from 21 to 128. 33. After changing the row height to 128, click on the blue OK button now. Step 34. The first row should now appear much taller as seen here. 35. Click into cell A2 and type the word mountain without the quotation marks and then hit the tab key once to jump to the next cell. 36. Key in height into the next cell and hit the tab key once to jump to the next cell. So it should say mountain, and then on the very next cell it says height in meters. And then when you hit that tab key again, it will highlight the next cell. 37. Take your mouse and click on the letter A for the first column, which I'm circling now. The entire column should become highlighted straight down. 38. Right click on the letter A of the first column, and a context menu should appear out of the letter A. 39. Select Resize Column from the context menu. 40. The Resize Column A window should open. Key in the number 108 to change the column width to 108. Hit the enter key once to exit the window. 41. Now, key in this information into the cells of the spreadsheet. So notice we're at A3, key in the word Everest. And then the height will be 8848. in A4, it's K2. Then the height is 86, 11. In A5 is Kanchenjunga. With a height of 85, 86. In A6, hear the name La Hoste. The height is 85, 16. In A7 is Makalu. With a height of 84, 85. And then in A8, it's Cho Oyo. The height of 81, 88. In A9, here in the mountain name Dihalagili 1, the height is 81.67, and then in A10, type Manaslu. With a height of 81.63. In A11, key in the mountain name Nanga Parbat. And you'd hit the tab key. And the height there is 81.26. Then in A12, it's the sea level. And hit the tab key, and the height there is 0. Now I'm going to pause the video here and let you key in the rest of that and let all the students catch up. And then we'll continue to 42. Step 42, welcome back everyone. Now, after entering the information, take your mouse and highlight cells from A3 to B12. So they would all be highlighted like this. And you do that by taking your mouse and clicking in A3 in the center of where it says Everest, holding down the mouse clicker, and drag across and down all the way to where it says 0, and then let go. 43. Use the keyboard shortcut Alt-I-H to open the Insert Chart window, or you can just click on the chart icon, which looks like a little chart on your menu bar. So either the shortcut or click on the icon to insert the chart. Step 44, click on the tab called Chart Types. Step 45, the window should change to show more charts as seen here. Step 46, select the top chart by clicking on it, and it will look like this. You'll have bars or columns and then a red line. 47. Click on the blue insert button after selecting the correct chart type. 48. Move the chart so that both the data and the chart are visible at the same time. You can move a chart by dragging the top portion of the chart to the location that you desire. So you take your mouse pointer and you go up towards the top, but not on the line or on the square, but maybe a millimeter or two below the top line. And then you hold down the mouse clicker and you move the mouse pointer down and the chart moves. 49. After moving the chart to below the data, click within cell A14 and key in your name inside of the cell A14. Add a chart title by right-clicking on the top portion of the chart and selecting the word title. This menu will appear as seen here. 51. Type highest mountains into the text box and then hit the enter key to insert this title into the chart. You are done with this particular project. 'Pause it here and check everyone to make sure that they're all done with their project and the chart. Okay, welcome back. We're now going to go in and work with largest canyons on the earth. Number one, open a new blank spreadsheet within Google Sheets. And that can be done by clicking on File, and then clicking on New, and then going across and down to Sheets. Once you have a new Google Sheet, give it the name Project 14 Largest Canyons. And you give it the name by typing in the new name up here where it says Untitled. Just click in there and then type in Project 14 and then the word, or the words, largest canyons. 2. Using the skills learned from the past projects, I'll need you to create a spreadsheet as shown here. So you have the book in front of you. You may need to go back a few pages to see what you did to create this large cell and to put in the words largest canyons in there. Then you have the word canyon and depth, and then these two canyons. After you put in this data, then you make the chart that goes with this data. And you resize it by dragging the corners, just like you would resize an image. You make it smaller, and then you position it and move it right here to the right of that data. After doing that, key in the next series of data, which is starting here in A7. It says canyon and then length. Type in the names of the canyons there. Now as you're typing in the name Grand Canyon, it'll try to say, oh, do you mean the first one? Just keep on typing and then you hit the tab key after finish typing the entire name, and then you put in the length. After putting in this data, highlight the data with the tiles or titles, and then you'll need to create a chart. One easy way to create the chart is after highlighting the data, click on the Insert Chart icon, or use the shortcut Alt-I-H. Now, if you're having problems with inserting the tables and putting them where you want them, just raise your hand and I'll come around and help you. I'll pause the video here and give you time to create the two charts. These are comparing the depths and the other is comparing the lengths of the canyons. You'll need to resize the charts to fit the area next to the data as shown in this picture here. So let's pause it now. Okay, welcome back. Now we'll be ready for the next project. This is now the largest geysers on the earth. Number one, open a new blank spreadsheet within Google Sheets. This is done by clicking on File and then going down to New and then across and down to where it says Google Sheets. After you have a new Google Sheets before you, name it Project 15 Largest Geysers. And that is done by typing in the versus untitled and then typing in the name Project 15 Largest Geysers. Two, using the skills learned from the past projects, create the spreadsheet shown here. So it'll say largest geysers, and then geyser name will be here. The height will be on the next column. And after putting in all the data, you should create a chart that compares the height. I'll pause the video here at this place so that you can key in the information. Welcome back. Alrighty, now we're ready for larger seas and oceans on the earth. Number one, open a new blank spreadsheet within Google Sheets. This is done by clicking on File and going down to New and then across and down to Google Sheets. Once you have a new blank Google Sheet, name it Project 16 Largest Seas and Oceans. Number two, using the skills learned from the past projects, create the spreadsheet shown here. So it's going to have this title here, and that's done with word art. Then all the names of the bodies of water, their depths or areas, and then create the chart from the data. You'll need to resize the chart and move the chart in the right place. And that's a lot of information, so I'm glad you have that in your book. If you're watching on YouTube, just pause the video at this point to key in the top part of the information. And then pause it again for this information here. And I'll pause the video here for my class so that they can put in the information. Okay, welcome back everyone. Now, on our next project, we have largest objects of the solar system. Now we're going to exclude the sun because the sun is so large, it's so massive, that it makes all the other objects look like they're specks of dust, basically. So if we make a chart and we include the sun into it, you'll see the sun and then you'll see little tiny dots for everything else. Number one, we need to open a new blank spreadsheet within Google Sheets. This is done by going to File, down to New, and then across and down to Google Sheets. After you have a new Google Sheets opened up, give it the name Project 17 Largest Objects of the Solar System. Number two, you need to create this data here. So you need a key in this data where we have the object and the diameter in miles. And so this is word art where it says largest objects of the solar system. And then down here in the second row, it says excluding the sun. And then we have the object. So the word object goes into A3 in the diameter. So we have the sun at 865,000 miles. Mercury, 3,030 miles. Venus, 7,520. Earth, 7,927. Mars, 4,217. Cirrus, 600. The actual size of Cirrus is smaller than 600, actually. But any number smaller than 600, and it doesn't appear on your chart. So that's why it's at 600. Jupiter, 88,500. Saturn, 75,000. Uranus, 32,500. Neptune, 32,000. Pluto, 1,770, which is smaller than our moon. The Earth's moon, if you wanted to add it, would be 2,159.7 miles. After putting in the data, create a chart, and then resize the chart and move it so it fits right here, as shown in the picture. I'll pause the video here so you can key in the information. Next topic, questions for lesson number 11. Now, many of these questions are the same ones that we asked in lesson number 10. Well, what I'd like you to do is email me if you're taking these for credit. You'll need to email me the answers. If you're taking this class for enrichment, you don't need to email me the answers because you're doing it for your own knowledge. Question number one, are numbers or letters used to designate rows? Question number two, are numbers or letters used to designate columns? Number three, does Google Sheets work offline? Question number four, can Google Sheets open a Microsoft Excel workbook? Number five, what is the name of this tool? Number six, what is the name of this tool? Question number seven, what is the name of this tool? Question number eight, what is the name of this tool? Question number nine, what is the name of this tool? Question number 10, What is the name of this tool? Question number 11. Which keyboard key is tapped to jump to the next cell? What does the function sum do? Number 13, what does the function max do? What does the function min do? 15. What does the tool look like that highlights all of the cells within the spreadsheet or workbook? 16. Please draw the fill color tool. 17. Please draw the currency tool. 18. Please draw the percentage tool. 19. Please draw the undo tool. Okay, well, there you have it. That was lesson number 11. Going over Google Sheets. Please comment and rate the video. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Thank you again. Bye-bye.